next. As we mentioned, the Godfather is in the house. He'll see singles action against Lance Storm. Seriously. This week, WWF Metal is brought to you by Hungry Man from Swanson, a whole pound of the good hearty food men love.
And by Roadrunner Records, Resident Evil CD in stores now.
And by Paramount Pictures' new film, Clockstoppers, opens March 29th everywhere, rated PG.
Well, isn't it kind of ironic that we'd be talking about Clockstoppers and rated PG?
Vegas here in the Godfather.
Well, that always seems to happen this time of year. You know, you're only a couple of months after Christmas, and things tend to pick up after WrestleMania, just like they do here in the World Wrestling Federation. WrestleMania is kind of the springboard, KK, to the start of the new year, so to speak, for us.
Well, you got to think, you know, after you turn the calendar over to the new year, you got a few big events. Of course, you've got all the conventions. You've got Mardi Gras. I mean, that's, you know, Godfather's prime turf right there, and I think WrestleMania, he's probably going to do more business than ever before, what with all the people from the office coming down.
Hopefully, he'll bring the A, number one, the A crop to WrestleMania, if you know what I mean. When you talk about 67,000 people in one spot at one time, that's a lot of business, if you know what I'm saying.
That's a lot of business. Well, the Godfather is partying and celebrating, but we're going to stop all the fun right now and introduce Lance Storm. Lance Storm.
You're exactly right. Technically, very, very sound. Athletically, few people are his peer. In the last couple of weeks, Lance Storm has had some tremendous matchups. We've seen him against Edge, tremendous RVD. He can go with anybody.
Lance Storm is not only an intense competitor inside the ring, he's very intense outside the ring, intense about his workouts, as you can tell. He's a voracious reader, talking about literature and books all the time, really trying to put himself over. Smart coach, he says he's a lot smarter than you.
Please. He can say it all he wants. Is it the truth? I'm not sure.
I don't educated finest universities that Canada has to offer.
You talk about educated and guys that are intense. What about the whole Ric Flair Undertaker set?
Yeah, let's kind of set up this whole thing with some matches that were made this past week. And we knew that there was a lot of talk about Ric Flair and the Undertaker. Whoa. Ric Flair really put into a position where he could not say no to the Undertaker, and he said yes this week.
Exactly. When you talk about beating up his best friend in Arn Anderson, his son in David Flair, Ric Flair had no other choice. But now the fact that Vince McMahon is back in complete control, at least until after WrestleMania, that's a big deal, and Vince McMahon is going to flaunt that leadership.
Yeah, the board of directors really was put in a position where they could not say no, and Vince McMahon did make a very convincing case this past week on Raw. So, listen, through WrestleMania, Ric Flair is not in charge, but then Vince McMahon takes that power one step further on SmackDown.
He wanted to make a point throwing Ric Flair out of the building, or so we thought Ric Flair had left, and booking David Flair against The Undertaker. We knew that wasn't an even matchup. Not fair at all.
No, I mean, David is just in his learning stage. He's 23 years old. He's not in The Undertaker's league. Lance Storm with a very smart move and rolls out of the ring. Gets out of the way. The momentum of The Godfather and another smart move. Although, now tasting some right hands. But, I mean, of course, it doesn't stop there.
Oh, wow.
It doesn't stop there because now Ric Flair thrown from the fire, frying pan into the fire thanks to his co-owner.
Well, and exactly, when you look at The Undertaker's record in WrestleMania, he's never lost.
Perfect, 9-0.
This is a matchup we've never seen at WrestleMania. It's a fantasy matchup,
ooh,
but Ric Flair's not taking it as a fantasy.
Big move off the top rope. Godfather, though, kicks out at two, but the damage is done. And now the fact that really, does this matchup play to The Undertaker's strengths now that Vince McMahon has made it no DQ?
Without a doubt, The Undertaker, the more brutal the matchup, the better he is. Ric Flair, in my opinion, is at a disadvantage, but he can be dirty too.
Oh, he certainly can, because Ric Flair's reputation was being the dirtiest player in the game. Lance Storm misses with the big elbow. That was going to be it for the Godfather. We know that Ric Flair was the dirtiest player in the game. Can he still be now 10 years removed from his prime? We'll find out. Ric Flair's going to be fighting for his life this Sunday at WrestleMania. WrestleMania against The Undertaker. A part of what people are calling the greatest WrestleMania card in history. Godfather, a lot of momentum now, Coach.
I would say that it's the greatest WrestleMania card of all time. And the Godfather, certainly, he can't wait to get up there for fan access this weekend and then WrestleMania this Sunday. I think everybody is on the edge of their seat for this Sunday. They don't know what to expect in Toronto.
Fans over 100 countries around the world will be seeing WrestleMania as Lance Storm just gets hit with a big old train.
Speaking of train, those were the old days.
Here we go now, up on the shoulders. Lance Storm slides down, puts himself in a good offensive position there, and just strikes